channel. I do hope you're doing well. Now, this video is going to be a lot before and a lot in because we're actually making our own Yorkshire pudding wrap. Yes, I know. And we're also making our own stuffing. So there is a lot of stuff happening. The stuffing you will just see a time lapse because that isn't part of the wrap, but I will be putting the recipe down below because these are both off BBC Good Food. What we will be doing as well is you'll see a pan over. I've cooked the meats, the stuffing, the potatoes, the veggies on to boil, and we are getting all sorted. And as I say, fingers crossed it actually works, but I'm not entirely sure. You will see a pan over of the ingredients. We're just going to go green beans and carrot in there. I was going to put peas and cabbage in there. I thought it might overrun. So I think what we're going to do, we're going to put horseradish and whole grain mustard and then wrap it all in, slice it, bit of gravy. You know how much we love a Yorkshire pudding wrap, so like pressure is on with this. But let's get in with making our own stuffing and our own Yorkshire pudding wrap.
So here you see an overview. You'll see how everything got cooked beforehand, but this is the basis of what you need. Well, you can put whatever you want in it. That is the beauty of a Yorkshire pudding wrap. But first off, we're going to start with making the stuffing. So this is completely new. This is a sausage and apple stuffing. I will leave it down below. Good old BBC Good Food as always. So yeah, let's get the stuffing done and see how it goes for our first attempt trying to make some. Enjoy your night.
Central you are because you're literally balancing on everything at the moment. I have no room to film, but to do the wrap it's giving me a different recipe. So you know my standard is 120 flour, 200 milk, 4 eggs. This Yorkshire pudding isn't. This is 150 flour, 300 milk and 3 eggs. So I don't quite know how this is going to go, but we've got a new tin which fingers crossed it's going to work. And we shall see. This is the first part of the steak. It's going to be like a wrap in essence. So we shall see how it is because we've got to drizzle that with oil. But as I say, the stuffing and Yorkshire pudding. Stuffing and beef's cooking away now. So this will give me time to do the mixture and then it can go in the fridge, chill. And then once the beef's done and once the stuffing's done, then we will be back and hopefully concoct it. We've got to put the potatoes in about an hour's time. And then we need to put the veg. We're going to have cabbage, we're going to have carrots, and we're going to have peas. But, are you washing it? And I shall see you, hopefully, when it starts to make a Yorkshire pudding wrap.
Thank you.
collide, we break down, caving in to our doubts, faces filled with sadness, when words are said, we'll regret.
The rap kind of went a bit lopsided. I heard like a bang, and when I looked, the tray went in like that, and then it bowed because of the heat. So I don't actually quite know why that happened. It doesn't seem too bad. I flattened it down with a spoon, and it is still rollable. We're going to try and see best how this goes. I am going to push you on a time lapse if I do this, and probably you do like a little voiceover. But yeah, let's see how it goes, because I really want this to work. Fingers crossed.
Now, everything is slightly cooled. The potatoes still hot. The beef's a little bit cooler. So this isn't a problem, because when you add in the gravy and everything, it heats everything up. So as you can see, we've gone for horseradish and whole grain mustard. It would have been English mustard, but it didn't have any. I literally have no idea what I'm doing here, guys. I'm just chucking the beef on, trying to separate it, because this is what it showed in the BBC Good Food video. Literally slathering it on and hoping for the best. And then I go in with some potatoes. Look at that. A little bit of stuffing, all just chucked in there, and trying to evenly distribute it, because you don't want a lackluster wrap, do you? And then you will see the kerfuffle that I have when I add the vegetables and gravy, and the realization it may be too big.
Now, the stressful part. I'm going to pour a little bit of gravy. I don't want to pour too much in case it overspills or I end up burning myself. But now is the part where I have to wrap this. Pray for me. I feel like suddenly I've overfilled it. We're just going to do a drizzle of gravy, guys. Just a drizzle, because we're going to have a little ramekin on the side. But oh my God, I'm so nervous. That is a big boy. Right. So, let's see what Dan's reaction. Beep, 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 beep.
Is that one or two?
That's one.
What?
That's one huge wrap.
Okay.
Right, now we need to do the taste test. One sec. So, you would have just seen an overview of the presentation, because I've got a little box. I'm trying to like get better pictures for the boxes, but Mum hasn't seen the box style or the Yorkshire pudding wrap. So, let's have a look. She's in her Bob Marley top.
No, but no cry.
So this is the
I
new...
I had to wake myself off the bed, viewers. Oh my God!
So that's the little photo box as well. Oh, so I have all the lights on. Take a closer look at the masterpiece. Look at all the different layers.
Oh, that's good. Is that mine?
I did ask her if she wanted one.
No, I was only joking. I've had a triple chicken sandwich, viewers.
But yes, that is a. So that little box is like, I'm going to try and put stuff in. There's different colour backdrops and everything like that. But, oh, goodness gracious, my lemonade. But yeah, ooh, that's the little thing. And then there's a little flap where I can lift it up and take pictures. I can put the camera down there if something was facing up.
What's this?
That's just the certificate.
So was that a good thing? So what is the idea for this box then?
Just something so that I have a plain background. And
here's my next trick.
Trust me. It's a way of like, yeah, putting your hand to try and grab the food. Just something
what,
that you
just
can make like,
more presentable.
Yeah, and like I can, if I put the green behind it, I can put like any background on it.
Well, this has got a coloured background.
I've just put the black in because I wanted black on
white.
Oh,
you've got different colours?
Yeah, yeah, they're all in the little carry bag, but I wanted black because I bought a new plate, guys. The plate, I don't know if you'll recognise, it is a new plate. So we've got a lovely white plate with a gold trim, but yeah, this is the
If you did a cheesecake then, you might have a different colour bottom and background.
Yeah, or I could put a green thing screen or something. And put But black will show
that's
up.
Good.
Black will just be black, yeah, so the way I want it is just the dish as the focus of the thing.
Where did you get all this, the little box?
Amazon. Oh, guys, the green screen is up there. I showed Mum the green screen today.
Do you want this?
Huh?
Do you want this?
Why? Is it not nice?
No, it's putting your picture.
Oh, no, I've got my half here.
Oh, this is half.
That's your half.
Yeah, go on, Daniel Pike. Go on, Daniel Son.
That's half.
I don't want to crack
it. Look at it in the box. It looks so cool. Oh, God, I've almost fell over there. How cool does it look? I just got some good pictures of that.
Yeah, that's her off and that's your off. Get in there, Daniel Son.
I was going to say, mine don't look like that.
Hey, mine was the one that was
starting as well.
I was sitting there thinking, I don't want to start tucking into it because you're off and I'm thinking...
No, that's your off. Way. That's her off.
I didn't realise. Wow.
I mean, it did go a bit lopsided because the tray bent, which was annoying. One side's slightly more crispy.
So you've done that thing and you put all the veg in the middle and roll it and cut it.
Once I edit it, I'll show you the steps beforehand
how to get it. Okay, then.
Because I think you'd like it. It's got horseradish, mustard in.
No. Dad just texts me, do I want some chilli? And I'm waiting for him to say, is it hot or not?
But yeah, that's the new little photo box, guys. I'm going to try and set up and put the pictures of the bits in so it's a bit more presentable. And
how much was the box, or can you not 20. Say? Oh, that's not too bad.
But you can adjust like the lighting and
you
everything.
You know what I'll do? I'll take it as it's a little thing.
It is a little carry bag.
Yeah, then when I go to the shops, I'll say, excuse me, I just want to put something in here. But I don't know how to vlog, do I?
Well, that's something we need to teach you for this year. So I'm gonna get a few more shots and then are you sure you don't want a bit?
No, I'm all right, thank you.
Okay,
yeah,
because
yeah.
I know people are gonna say Mama G didn't taste test this one.
No, or if you have a little bit left, leave it, but I've opened my sandwich.
Okay, right. Well, I'll be taking the first few bites because I need to get the full effect of it.
Yeah, all right,
and
then,
you can have some.
Bye.
Right, I'll see you in a bit, guys. Right, this is gonna be very testing, guys, because it is very large, but I just walked in and Dan said something about it.
Definitely the best one that we've had this year.
Number one, the size of it. It has a little bit overspilled. I said to Dan, I do think...
A little bit.
I do think I overfilled it. But I'll show you the pictures actually from when I was doing it. The way when I had it all, I would literally just drizzle gravy and then chop it up and have it like that as well. But... Okay.
Do me a favour.
Okay. What?
Toast test it into the camera. Without spilling a drop.
I lost a potato and some carrots.
Oh, that was already out.
Apart from the tray going a bit lopsided, because Dan's is, I think, the crispier side. Sorry.
Still tastes good.
Now, I wouldn't mind getting messy at a Christmas market for this. Not when it's the little pappy ones that is all the juice comes out. There's no juice coming out of it.
No, I don't want to get messy, but definitely. I like the little pot of gravy.
Yeah.
I like that. Like a dipping sauce. Oh, sugar.
You just dropped it in the gravy?
Yep. Where's me? Did I have a knife? fork.
I've got your fork just under the camera.
Damn.
Hold on. Multitasking you guys.
Stay there, because you're gonna lose it.
There we go. It's all good.
Here we go.
The stuffing is lovely.
Yeah.
I feel that's going to be another thing we're mastering on our Sunday dinners. Nice bit of horseradish and whole grain mustard, bit of seasoning.
Tasty.
A little bit, yeah. Guys, I'm pretty impressed. If I do say so myself.
I don't think we'll be going to meet to the markets next year.
Make our own.
Yeah.
And literally, I know we put a lot in, but I didn't think it was a lot. It's just when you start rolling it, it's like, oh, maybe it was a little bit much.
Okay. I know we bought a tin for it. Could we possibly not look at trying to make, buy a larger tin?
Even bigger? Okay.
Because you think, if you, the more space you've got, the more spaced, like your
level
will expand out. You can half it, and then that way you get more in, surely.
So, in the recipe, it says when the Yorkshire comes out to halve it. I didn't, because I didn't want to risk, like, you could do it and then it broke. So I literally just rolled the whole thing. So our tin was 35 by 25. It said 40 by 30. We couldn't find that. If you guys know of any, like, big baking trays that are, like, bigger than that, where we can get them, please do let us know, because Dan wants to do a huge one now. How much do you reckon you could charge at Christmas market for something this size? 15. Well, not saying that, the one that we had at Winter Wonderland was 13.
That was okay. But I think this would just knock socks off of that one. You know, to the point of, like, you'd go back specifically just for that.
This is like the ultimate Yorkshire pudding wrap. And everything was homemade.
Thing is, though, it just sounds like you're blowing your own trumpet, but you're actually not. It genuinely tastes better. Considering we went to the one in Thing, and it was like water.
But hold on.
Go on.
Does this beat last year's Tesco one?
Mm.
Yeah? Okay, because that was the one to beat, guys. That was the one to beat.
That was the one. You smashed it.
So we've done it with beans and carrots. I think peas and cabbage could work in this. I just don't think anything with florets.
You're thinking mostly parsnips.
I was just thinking mashed swede as well.
You definitely need a bigger wrap.
Or...
well,
if this was done at Christmas time, turkey, pigs in blankets.
Mm.
Dan loves his cranberry sauce.
Thing is, you could do the pigs in blankets yourself.
Mm.
Just to get the sausage and
wrap it around bacon. Yeah. I didn't try a bit of gravy on it, guys. Let's try this. Does it complete it? Let's have a look.
I hardly didn't dribble it on.
I did.
Yeah. Once you just realised.
There's
like 2-3 bites in. I was like, all right, get that on there.
I put a little bit on the actual thing, but I didn't want to put too much because I didn't want it to soak wrap. So I only done a little bit on it. And the pictures looked well good in the little
left to show me.
Cabby hole, yeah.
Mmm. And you know what?
Well,
the Yorkshire's actually holding its shape well. Like, it's not... The ones we get, they're almost like cakey-like. They're like spongy.
I think they're an Aunt Bessie.
You reckon?
I reckon they're an Aunt Bessie special.
I think what we could do, next time we have a roast, any leftovers, because we have actually got Aunt Bessie's as well. We went icing and got them as like kind of a backup in case this went belly up. We could maybe, if we had leftovers from a roast, chuck it in an Aunt Bessie, wrap it and see how that tastes or how that fares, and then we'll be able to tell if they're an Aunt Bessie.
Mm-hmm.
I do think the one at Winter Wonderland though was a homemade Yorkshire because it was a lot more puddingy.
I think you can tell a homemade Yorkshire to a bought one from, you know, when you roll it and the way it cracks.
Yeah.
The Aunt Bessie's always crack on the
yep.
top. But homemade ones, they just sort of bend.
Like, you guys know me. Me and Mum never used to make our own Yorkshires. Mum used to get the Tesco Finest beef dripping. Oh, love them. And it was only a few years back now, for Easter, I thought we had lovely roast lamb. I'm going to try making my Yorkshires. I've never looked back.
That air is now.
Never looked back, and there's never been a ready-bought Yorkshire back in this house.
Hmm.
I say, but... If you have ready-made, that's, we're not knocking or anything, we're just saying it's easier than you think, because I always thought, oh, Yorkshire puddings, it's going to take this, and you've got to do this, and you've got to get the oil, and la la. You could even make the batter the night before, because the longer time it has to chill, the better.
Just preserve it right, cover it with cling film in the fridge.
Mm. Oh, I don't do that. You're supposed to wrap it.
If you leave it overnight.
Oh. I just chuck it. I normally give mine at least like a good 40 minutes to chill.
Stay to me.
It's on his bed.
It's disgusting.
But yeah, they're literally, I'll leave the BBC Good Food Yorkshire pudding recipe down below as well. Just in case you guys want to try. I'm going to break Mum a bit off you. Mum? I said to her, I said, you coming in? She went, no, I've got Deal or No Deal. I'll be like, all right. Let's break Mum a bit off with everything on. I'm going to put my bit there because I'm going back to my bit, but let's see. Mama tasting hers. I thought I got it down my new loungewear set then.
I've just got a phone call from Brenda.
Oh, okay.
she's got a new number.
All right.
I thought she died.
Well, that's good to know. Do you want to pop in and try your little bit on here, on camera, see what you think?
Go on.
Mama G can sit down next to me. I've got to be careful because my thing.
I pushed up.
You rushed up?
No, we need to get them all off.
Issues, guys. So that's your bit. That's got all your bit in. Dip it in the gravy. Oh, do whatever you want.
Oh.
You can just...
I've got to try and find out how to hold it first.
Yeah, you do like that.
Oh.
Mum wouldn't be good at Winter Wonderland. Get your lips around it.
Yeah. Oh. That's falling apart. Oh, it's all right.
Oh, we'll get you used to it.
You're not eating all this.
Yeah, I'll eat the rest of mine. I wanted to see what you thought of yours.
Yeah, very good. I bank out it's basic diet, you know.
Well, but it's healthy though.
A triple chicken.
Oh well, yeah, Mum's had a lot more treat than me. It's basically like a giant toad in the hole with a roast dinner in, basically, ain't it?
Roasting is inside.
Oh, Dad, well, what's this? And you'll have to make Dad one. I'll have to run it down.
Dada will probably actually make his own. He actually don't mind a bit of cooking.
Got a tissue?
Dan's on tissue, Jimmy.
Thank you.
I'm all right, thank you.
Oh, yeah, it's all right, isn't it? And how much would you pay for this at Winterbottom? Well, we paid £10, didn't we?
We've paid £10 and £13 this year, and they've not been anywhere near 13, that size.
The £13 was the better one, but...
Yeah, Winter Wonderland was better, but it was still like, you bit into it and it still had the juice come out. Like, there's not been any juice from the veg come out of that.
No, I'll give you that.
And also, this is your homemade one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Why? Well, when these people see them on their Royal Mail, not Royal Mail, the Daily Mail, they'll say, oh, my goodness, who's that? Could you do us 100 wraps for us?
I said, how much? You could easily charge £15 for that thing for the size of it. Would you pay for my Yorkshire pudding wrap, guys? Let me know down below. So what are you watching? You're watching Deal or No Deal, weren't you? Have you eaten your sandwich or are you eating it now?
I've eaten that.
Oh, so this is like a...
I've done my first thing of lemonade. I'm just going to fill up. I've just rung Dennis, my friend. Because he was wondering what happened to me. I said, well, I...
Oh, your mum had a phone drama, guys.
Yeah, had a bit of a blip. But I said to him, come tomorrow, text me and I'll go and get your bills.
Okay. So what would you give it?
Nine and a half.
9.5.
Yes.
Okay, I'll take that. Left a carrot in my gravy, but it's okay.
Thank you, viewers.
But yeah,
I'm just going to eat my pot Pringles now.
Have you been putting it in your nutrition log?
Yes. I've done it for the first 2 days. I've got to remember what I've eaten. But I ain't had much. I'm just fighting it hard with the alcohol.
Not doing it, guys.
Some of the viewers said to Shannon they're concerned for my alcohol consumption.
Oh, yeah.
But I was ill, wasn't I?
Yeah.
You know, I do
but
have
in nearly
to...
every vlog you was drinking, weren't you?
Shannon? I'm 64. Oh, goodness me. If I want a glass of wine or a little tipple of...
People was just worried because it was a lot.
What do you mean it was a lot? What, a glass of wine?
No, you was like just swigging the brandy from the bottle.
Yeah, I know, because it was medicinal and the little bottle was only plastic, wasn't it?
Oh, it's not like a big bottle. That makes a difference.
Yeah.
So you give it 9.5?
Yeah, maybe even more. So next time I'll do one for me.
I was going to say, well, when I do the roast dinner, maybe next weekend we'll have another wrap.
Oh, that's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
We're going into the, what's that paper I just said?
Daily Mail.
I'm going to send it to Daily Mail. Shannon needs to send it and we need to get her branching out. Tell us what you think, viewers. Who would like to have Shannon's hot pot? No.
Yorkshire pudding wrap. Well, it seems to have gone down. Well, guys, I mean, Dan said, like, best one so far this year. I take that as a 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
And I think it's pretty darn good myself. So, if you did enjoy the video, guys, you know what to do. Hit that thumbs up and subscribe down below.
Was you showing the viewers how you was making it?
Mm.
Oh, that's good.
I'll show you because it's quite easy. We'll have to let Mum do the wrap and see how she feels with it once.
My name is Mama G. I like to be. Her name is Shan. She does a good Dan. That's the wrap. That's the wrap, viewers.
Guys, I'm going to stuff my face off this Yorkshire pudding wrap now. Hope you enjoy like the new thumbnail. We're going to play around with them pictures, see how they go. Who knows? It might make it, it might not. But yes, take care. We'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.
Bye.